Who's the bigger builder, humans or nature? Hello, my younglings. I was just browsing through my device and noticed that you've built quite a lot of settlements and cities, far more than back when I first visited your human villages. But where did you get the idea to build all that? Maybe you've seen some of the many builders in nature? Yes, you're right. Birds are well-known builders. Do you know any others? Let me hear it. I'm sure you know. Just think a bit. Who said that? Yes, ants are very skilled builders too. Anyone else want to add something? All right, I'll tell you about some other builders from nature. There are many, but I'll single out a few for this episode. Let's start with birds. The first thing to know is that not all birds build nests. For example, emperor penguin fathers carry their precious egg on their feet to keep it off the frozen ground. Some birds, like cuckoos, lay their eggs in other birds' nests. Others lay them on the ground among leaves or pebbles, or on cliffs with very little protection. For the birds that do build nests, there is one main goal: to keep their eggs and chicks safe. Some birds, like swallows, build mud nests and attach them to the walls of houses. Swallows are exceptional nest builders, using their skills to create unique and functional nests that will be warm and comfortable homes for them and their young. Swallows use mud as the main material for building their nests. The mud helps them create a solid structure. In addition to mud, they also use dry leaves, grass, and small twigs to line the inside of the nest. Sometimes, they add small pebbles for extra stability. Swallows choose nest sites that are protected from predators and are usually found near water, such as trees, buildings, or even barns. They start by shaping the base of the nest using mud. They form a small wall or structure that will serve as the foundation. The swallows shape the mud with their feet and beaks, making sure the nest is bowl or cup-shaped, deep enough to hold the eggs and baby swallows. During construction, they add dry leaves, grass, and other materials inside the nest to make it comfortable and warm. Once they finish building, the swallows leave the nest to dry. The mud will harden and become a solid structure capable of withstanding various weather conditions. Swallow nests are not only shelters for eggs and chicks, but also an important part of the ecosystem. Swallows help control insects, making them beneficial for agriculture and the environment. Swallows often return to the same places each year to reuse their nests. Other birds, like eagles or falcons, build their nests high in trees using branches. Each bird chooses a place that will be safe for its chicks. Many birds also make their nests in tree hollows, including parrots. This is just one of the reasons why it's important not to cut down trees. Meanwhile, kookaburras, small birds similar to parrots that live in Australia, use their strong beaks to dig into termite mounds and create a cozy nest inside. Kookaburras are also known for their calls, which sound like human laughter, and the cute spotted pardalotes will dig small tunnels into the slopes of the earth with a safe and comfortable place for their eggs at the end of the tunnel. Black-capped reed warblers use a different kind of glue, sticky spider webs. They sew grasses together using the web, which also helps make their nests strong and resistant to wind and water. However, they need to master the technique of collecting the spider webs, as otherwise it could get tangled in their feathers. Magpies and crows, frequent visitors to our gardens, are also skilled nest builders. Not only can they expertly arrange twigs into the shape of a cup or flower pot, but they also use many materials made by humans. You can see them using fabric, rope, or wire to secure their nests. Some birds, like red kites, have even been seen decorating their nests with human waste. Australian crows line the inside of their nests with a thick layer of kangaroo droppings, then add soft feathers to keep their chicks warm. Building process. To actually weave their nests, birds typically start by creating a foundation, arranging twigs or branches in a place they choose. They then use their beaks and feet to thread the selected materials and secure the branches in place. Birds can weave strips of material up and down with their beaks, similar to carpet weaving. They are even capable of tying knots. Nests can take a long time to build and are often reused year after year. Weavers are so skilled at weaving that they can construct complex nests that cover entire trees and have multiple chambers. In short, birds are truly intelligent creatures. They use their intelligence, along with their beaks and feet, to find the smartest ways to build nests from the materials available to them. They get better at it by learning from others, like their parents or peers. And do you know which are the strongest birds in the world? you don't know. The title of the strongest bird belongs to some massive eagles, such as the harpy eagle and the martial eagle from Central and South America, the African hunting eagle, the Philippine eagle, and the New Guinea eagle. The harpy eagle and the Philippine eagle can be over 3 feet long from the strong beak to the end of the tail, with a wingspan twice as wide. Their legs are extremely powerful, 1.2 to 1.6 inches thick, with sharp talons that resemble daggers. The hind talons can be as long as 2.70 inches, nearly the same size as the claws of a large brown bear. These powerful eagles around the world hunt prey that is nearly as heavy as they are, including monkeys, sloths, small kangaroos, and antelopes. The female harpy eagle can weigh as much as 20 pounds, while the males are half that size, and she can pull an adult monkey from a tree. What's that? You didn't know birds could be that strong? Would you like to hear a few more interesting facts about birds? Great, I'll tell you more after I share a bit more about other builders from nature. In addition to birds, beavers are also very well known as talented builders. To build their homes, beavers use wood, branches, and twigs. They are excellent swimmers and often collect materials from rivers and lakes. Beavers have sharp front teeth that help them cut down trees and branches. They can easily cut through large trees and use them to build their dams and lodges. Beavers build dams to stop the flow of water, creating calm waters where they feel safe. These dams are made using wood, mud, and stones. The dams can be very large and sometimes reach heights of several meters. Once the dam is finished, beavers build their nests or lodges, which are located in the water. The nests are made of twigs and grass, and they are warm and dry inside. Beavers often retreat to their lodges when they feel threatened. In beaver families, everyone helps with building and maintaining the dam and lodge. This helps them stay organized and successful. Martens are also excellent at building their shelters and have interesting ways of doing so. Martens are very resourceful and intelligent animals that can often be seen in forests and urban areas. Martens gather various materials to build their homes. They are very active and often climb trees, which allows them to find different materials for construction. This includes twigs, leaves, bark, and even old paper or fabrics they find. They use their sharp teeth and paws to cut and shape the materials. Their nests are usually made in tree cavities, but sometimes they use holes in the ground or beneath smaller rocks. Their nests are typically lined with soft materials to make them warm and comfortable. Martens use their nests as shelters from predators and bad weather. Inside, their young are often found, protected from the elements and other predators. Field mice are also small and cheerful builders in nature. They create their shelters in the ground, which help protect them from predators and bad weather. Field mice gather various materials, such as grass, leaves, and small twigs. Sometimes they also use feathers or fur they find in nature. When they find a suitable place, field mice build a nest by shaping the collected materials into a cozy ball or small house. Nests are usually placed in safe spots, such as under bushes or in tall grass. They can also dig holes in the ground with their front paws, turning them into a nest and shelter. Nests are important for field mice because they provide safety. Inside the nest, mice are protected from rain, cold, and predators like owls or snakes. Additionally, nests are places where mice can rest and raise their young. Field mice often live alone, but in some cases, they gather in small groups. They are very active and frequently search for food, such as seeds, roots, and greens. Their ability to move quickly and hide helps them survive in the wild. What do you think? Are there any plants that are builders? You don't know? Well, I'll tell you soon. Before I tell you, did you know that fish are builders too? They are true masters at creating habitats in the water. Some fish, like goldfish or xyshlis, build special nests made of small stones, sand, or plants. In these nests, females lay their eggs, and the males guard the eggs until they hatch. Fish like cleaners, for example, cleaner fish, use their teeth to dig holes in the sand or remove debris from their habitats. These fish help keep the water clean and create a healthier environment for other fish. Fishes like piranhas use their strong teeth to shape habitats from plants and corals. They often use twigs and leaves to create hidden passages and shelters within their habitats. Fish build their habitats to provide security and protection. In these habitats, they can hide from predators, find food, and raise their young. Ants are among the most well-known builders in nature. They create complex structures called anthills, and they do so in a very clever way. These tiny workers use their bodies and strength to build their homes and provide safety for the entire colony. Ants use different materials to build their anthills. This can include earth, sand, leaves, or twigs. Some ants, like wood ants, even use pieces of wood and resources from their environment. When building their anthill, ants dig tunnels beneath the surface of the earth. These tunnels are connected and form complex networks that allow ants to move within the anthill. These tunnels are often spiral-shaped and can be several meters deep. Inside the anthill, ants create different chambers for different purposes. For example, there's a chamber for eggs, a food storage chamber, and chambers for the queen. These chambers are carefully organized so that the colony can function efficiently. Foxes also belong to this group of builders in nature. Foxes use their strong, curved claws to dig into the ground. They often dig to a depth of 1 to 2 meters, creating a complex system of tunnels and chambers. In the dens they build, foxes typically create several chambers that serve different purposes. For example, one chamber may be for sleeping, while another may be for food storage. Foxes sometimes line the inside of their dens with dry leaves, grass, or fur to create a comfortable resting place and a safe environment for raising their young. Foxes are usually solitary, but during the mating season, they may gather in pairs or small groups to care for their young together. Their ability to build and maintain shelters plays a crucial role in their survival in the wild. Spiders are true masters of construction. They use their special glands to produce silk, which helps them create webs. These webs are not only beautiful, but also very functional. A spider first creates several initial threads that stretch from one point to another. These threads help form the foundation for its web. Then, the spider starts adding longer threads, connecting them to a central line. Once the basic structure is complete, the spider adds finer threads to reinforce the web. The webs are essential for catching prey, such as flies and other insects. When an insect falls into the web, the sticky threads trap it, allowing the spider to easily capture it. The webs also serve as protection from rain and predators. Now let me tell you that some plants can also be called builders. For example, succulents and cacti create special structures inside themselves that help them retain moisture. They build their bodies in such a way that they can survive in dry conditions, collecting and storing every drop of water they gather when it rains, which is a rare occurrence in deserts. In the desert, scorpions also live and dig shallow holes in the desert sand to hide from the heat during the day. Desert scorpions create simple burrows that allow them to preserve moisture and stay cool in the scorching desert conditions. Bees are also incredible builders, creating their hives as homes for their colonies. To construct these hives, bees use wax that they produce themselves. This wax is gathered and shaped into small pieces. Bees chew the wax to soften it and make it easier to shape. Then, using their legs and mouths, they create honeycombs. The honeycomb consists of small hexagonal cells, which are perfect for storing honey and pollen. Bees build their hives by connecting many pieces of honeycomb. A hive can have different compartments, with each cell serving its specific purpose for storing food, raising new bees, or housing the queen. Hives are crucial for bees because they provide safety and a place to live. Inside the hive, bees are protected from predators and harsh weather conditions. Additionally, hives allow bees to easily collect honey and pollen. And for the final part of the episode, as promised, here are some more fascinating bird facts. The largest flying bird is the albatross. The albatross has the largest wingspan, measuring 10 feet from the tip of one wing to the tip of the other. The goose was the first bird domesticated by humans. The fastest bird in the world is the peregrine falcon. It usually reaches speeds of 217 miles per hour during a dive. And according to National Geographic, the highest measured speed was 241 miles per hour. A species of poisonous birds was discovered in the forests of Papua New Guinea. After consuming toxic food, these birds produce toxins which they store in their feathers. Pigeons can see ultraviolet radiation. The ostrich's eye is larger than its brain. A bird's heart beats 400 times per minute. And while flying, it can beat up to 1,000 times per minute. The lyrebird can imitate the calls of up to 40 different birds. Eagles have the longest lifespan among birds, living up to 70 years. That would be all for today, my little friends. Write to me about what else you'd like to learn. Until the next episode, you can also become a builder by, for example, building a birdhouse where you can leave food and water for the birds. That way, you can help birds that don't have shelter. And don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss the next episode. Yours truly, Troll Mitros, naturally.